They were convicted of some of the most heinous crimes in recent history, but that hasn't stopped some notorious killers from finding love and tying the knot behind bars. Joining us now to discuss the brides who have said I do to some of the worst is legal analyst Jonna Spillboard. Jonna, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
So let's start with Carol Ann Boone, who married infamous serial killer Ted Bundy
and claims
she gave birth to his child. What can you tell us about that?
All right, so Carol Ann Boone did not fall in love lightly. She fell hard. She started corresponding with probably the most infamous serial killer of our time back in the 70s, and then quickly moved herself to Florida to be closer to him. That's where their less than fairy tale wedding happened, and I'll tell you about that. She was actually testifying on his behalf in one of his trials when our most famous serial killer took advantage of a law that said if you declared you were married in a courtroom in front of a judge, voila, you're married. So while she was testifying, he proposed and they were officially married on the stand. That same day, he was sentenced to death for the third time.
Okay, we're going to move on now to killer brothers Lyle and Eric Menendez. What can you tell us about older brother Lyle's marriage to Rebecca Sneed?
All right, well, first of all, Lyle has been married not once, but twice behind bars. His first wife was a former model, Anna Erickson. She divorced him, why? Because he was pen-palling with other women from behind bars. That marriage ended, and then he married Rebecca Sneed, who actually is now an attorney, a former magazine editor, and they apparently have had a pretty terrific relationship for the last 14 years.
Okay, he's been cheating via pen pal. I've never heard that before.
Yeah.
What about the younger brother, Eric's wife, Tammy Sockerman?
So this is interesting too, because she started corresponding with him back in 1993. She had a child from a prior relationship who she brought to prison to meet Eric, referred to him as her earth dad, and they've been happily married ever since. But in case you're wondering, they're not allowed, neither of the Menendez brothers are allowed conjugal visits. So these relationships do not involve
relations. Yeah, I want to ask you about that then. How are they able to keep in these types of marriages, in these relationships?
You know, so the experts say this, that when you're in a relationship with somebody behind bars, you are the person in control. And it lends itself, you know, that when they say you're in the honeymoon phase, when you get all giddy and butterflies, well, that honeymoon phase never ends because nobody's there to leave the toilet seat up. They're not leaving the cap off the toothpaste. And that's a perfect recipe for somebody who wants this type of relationship.
And the psychology behind all this is just unbelievable.
Yeah.
Okay, well, Jonna, it's not just the men behind bars that are getting hitched. In 1987, Manson family member Susan Atkins, who was sentenced to life for her role in the infamous Manson murders, she married Harvard law graduate James Whitehouse. This is a wild story.
Totally wild. Now, okay, so James Whitehouse, he was kind of a low-level criminal. He was on drugs, couldn't get work. He was really sort of trying to find his way. So who does he reach out to? A Manson murderer. He reached out to Susan Atkins when she was in jail, having read her autobiography, started to visit her for inspiration to try to clean up his life. And you wouldn't think it, but it worked. He eventually went to Harvard Law School, became a lawyer. He's still practicing law to this day and stayed married to her until the day she died. It was about a 22-year marriage.
A really weird way. She actually inspired him to go to Harvard Law School.
And
who would have thought?
I know.
These are unbelievable stories, Jonna. Thank you so much for being here and providing your insight.
You.
Well, up next, I was on The Bachelor way back in 2004, and I've always been a romantic at heart. That's why I'm so excited to be hosting a brand new dating series from the creator of The Bachelor called The Proposal. It starts tonight, right after The Bachelorette. 10 hopeful romantics will compete in 4 pageant-style rounds and vie for a chance at love with a mystery suitor whose identity is concealed from them. Here's a sneak peek.
One hidden secret admirer.
Is it weird knowing none of us can see you?
It's exactly how I like it.
10 people looking for love.
I'm ready for the love that people write movies about.
A new series from the producers of The Bachelor.
Not every day you meet your future soulmate.
Where a chance at love.
In life, great rewards come while taking great risks.
Means taking a chance.
I feel like my heart's gonna explode.
And it all happens in 1 hour.
Will you marry me?
The Proposal.
Make sure you check out the premiere episode of The Proposal tonight at 10 Eastern, 9 Central on ABC.